Hello, hello, everybody at AVMS. So my name is Ilyana Capion. I have been a friend of Ms. Hassini since we were in high school. So we've been friends for a long time. And she reached out to me and asked me to give you kind of a view of what it's like to be a TV news reporter. Which is what I am, that's what I do. I grew up in Aliso Viejo and I went to DJAMS Middle School, not too far from AVMS. My brothers went to AVMS though, so we are house divided in that sense. I went to Aliso Niguel High School and graduated there. I cheered at my junior college, my community college, Orange Coast College, and then I got scouted to cheer at my university, Austin Peay State University in Clarksville, Tennessee, where I met my husband and studied broadcast journalism. So right now, it's really cold, but we are out on the scene this morning. A lot of police presence this morning out here, and that's what we're covering. So we've just been trying to get information all morning long. But I'm gonna take you along my day, that way you can get a feel for what it is that I do and what other people that I work with do. Stay with us, let's see how it goes.
Who's coming into our newsroom now of a large police presence and some SWAT vehicles in an area near a field in Northwest Bakersfield. 17th Ilyana Capion is joining us live from the scene as she learns a little bit more about what's going on out there. Ilyana, what can you tell us? What can you see out there right now?
Maddie, we just arrived here, and as you said, it is kind of dark. We are seeing just a field is where we're at, but if you look over in the distance, you can see some police presence.
So my favorite classes in middle school were probably drama and choir. I wasn't much of a math and science person, although I always tried to do my best in those classes as well. What I use the most is probably common sense, and I learned research a lot in middle school. So that's kind of when you get your feet wet into, you know, doing your own research, writing research papers and essays and things like that. And that transfers well into the job that I do now, because as a journalist, you know, you go out and you interview people, but you have to do research before you interview them, and then you have to do research after you interview them. It's kind of like a nonstop book report all the time, except for it's on TV.
All right, so I'm getting in my car. Now I am going to follow up with a little bit more investigation. So I'm going to reach out to some people that might know about what's going on here. So day's still going.
My typical day is different from day to day. So for me, I am the sunrise reporter, which means I work our morning show. So I wake up around 1:45 every morning, and I start at work at 3:30, and then the show starts at 5.
So during that time, I'm doing live hits. So basically, when you see somebody like your reporter at the grocery store at a fire, I'm that person that's at that fire at breaking news scenes. Or I'm introducing my package, and a package is basically the story that you see aired on the news. So that 2-minute story about the AVMS teacher of the year, I'd be the person that you hear their voice on that story, and I'd probably be the person at AVMS talking to the teacher of the year, presenting them their award and asking them how it feels to be teacher of the year. I am an outgoing person, and that helps me in my job. So you have to be willing to talk to people that sometimes don't really want to talk to you. You have to be willing to make phone calls to people even when you don't know who you're calling. So you have to be willing to do research and look stuff up. You have to do a lot of legwork before you actually get the finished product of a video. You also have to be creative, because a big part of this is making it interesting for you guys, the viewers.
And here we have Mickey. Mickey is a photojournalist for KGET.
Mickey!
Hi, Ilyana. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Doing excellent. It's a great Friday morning.
What are you doing? What's your job? What's your day-to-day?
So my day-to-day is I usually get in around 4 o'clock in the morning. I work the sunrise shift, so it's actually it's quite the battle. But I get in and check my assignments for the day, and right after that, it's just getting out in the streets of town and seeing if there's anything going on, fires, anything that's newsworthy, basically. And if there's breaking news, we'll report it. So every day is an experience when you're a photojournalist, and you get to see stuff that no one else gets to see. And meet a lot of people, so I think it's a good like social networking job too as well.
In school, you're learning how to communicate with all types of people, and you have to learn how to communicate, you know, with elders, as in your teachers, but you also have to communicate with your peers. So you learn that skill early on, and so that's something that I think I learned, and it's not just valuable for my career or the communications degrees, it's valuable for everyone in every career, because at the end of the day, if you don't know how to socialize with people and communicate, there's going to be a lot of issues that you run into. The most rewarding part is getting to tell people's stories and giving them a platform to share their stories, because a lot of the time, even though you're sharing one person's story, it connects with thousands of people. So one person's story, like, I don't know if people understand that. One person's story, me talking to you about how I became a journalist, isn't going to connect with just you, little Sarah. It's going to connect with, you know, a couple of people in your grade or a couple of people at your school. And if you share this, that many more people. So I think that, you know, sharing people's story is a true gift, and making them feel heard and cared about, because at the end of the day, that is the biggest thing that I go after, is I just want to make sure that people feel cared about and they know that what they're doing is important. Another part of the challenges of this career is burnout. It's very real, and it happens all the time because you're working long hours and you're constantly on the go. And that's something I'm still trying to figure out. I don't necessarily know how to handle burnout properly right now. Okay, so it is 12:51 and my day is over. This is early for me. Normally I don't get off this early, but we are off and I am headed home, but I'm not really off because I'm headed home to work on stories for the next day, next week. So the work continues, everybody. I know that I need to take some time for myself, and I think that that's a big thing that hopefully schools are teaching now, is, you know, mental health and taking care of yourself, because at the end of the day, if you don't take care of yourself, you're not gonna be any good to any job or any other person. But at the end of the day, you're in middle school right now, you're like 12, 13, maybe 14 years old. What people think of you right now as a 12-year-old is not what you are going to be, and it doesn't define who you are as a person. It definitely isn't going to define who you are as an adult either. So do what you want to do. Go for those classes that you wouldn't normally go for if you think that it's something you're interested in. Right now is the time to do anything, because really school's free for you right now. Take this opportunity and take all of those classes that you have a slight interest in and find out if you're interested in them a little bit more. So yeah, it's a day in the life of a live shot, and me as an MMJ, a reporter for KGET NBC News. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. Follow me on Instagram and you guys can get more behind the scenes stuff like this. I'm at Ilyana, Ilyana underscore on Instagram, or add me on Facebook, Ilyana Capion. That is my my news reporter page. I'm also on Twitter, but Instagram is what I'm the most active on. So if you want some more behind the scenes stuff, follow me on there and reach out, say hello, tell me where you guys are from and what you guys want to do. And if I can help out in any way, please let me know.